Hi guys, in this video I am going to show you how to create WDS in Windows Server 2016. First go to Server Manager. Next, installation types, role based or feature based installation. Okay. Server situation, this is my DC. This server. From here. Windows deployment service, add features, next, install. Installation succeeded. Oh, here is the WDS. Windows deployment service is not configured, so first we need to configure server. Next, integrate with Active Directory. Remote install the installation file location. You can change, but I am going to set a default. Yes. Later, finish, and this properties, okay, response all, that's fine, okay, would require after or continue the whatever you want, the options, client, okay, DHCP, if the DHCP is running on this server, okay. Advance, okay, demonstration recommended, network, okay, all fine, and I have already copied my ISO files here. This is Windows 10 and Server 2012. Mount both E drive and F drive, okay, here. Let's wait for a while. Okay, it is now install image. Add install image. I'm going to name it OS. OS. Install. Next. Browse. This is E and F. E. Sources install. Next, and this is Windows 10 Pro. I'm not going to install the Home Edition, Pro Edition. Okay, it will take some time. Okay, install it. I'm going to add another image. This is Server 2012. Finished, and I'm going to add boot image. Browse. This one is 10. Success. And boot. Next. Okay, that's fine. You can change the name and description, but I'm going to default name. Okay, now finish. I think single boot image will be fine for all these three installation file. This is my virtual machine. I'm going to boot through the PXE. Start. Okay. WS-S12. This is my WS server 203. Okay, fine. TFTP download. Trying to download the boot file. Yep. Meanwhile, if you have a driver for the specific component for your PC, you can load here the driver. Directive language. Next. From here you can choose your desired operating system. Next. Yep. That's all. Thank you for watching this video. Please don't forget like and subscribe. If you have any questions, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you.